Hey guys, what's up? JK with Porn Reboot here. Welcome to the series on the 5 rules of rebooting. Today we're going to be talking about rule number 2. Rule number 2 of rebooting is be honest. Now, porn addiction requires lying. You're lying about what you're watching, you're lying about how much you're watching it, and you're also lying about the consequences that your addiction to pornography and masturbation has on your life. Or you're minimizing it, or you're using these little white lies, or you're lying by omission. And that is going to hurt you. It's important to realize that the depth of the secrets you keep equals the depth of your addiction. Basically, you are as sick as your secrets. And the more you can open up and the more you can share, the less sick you're going to be, the less of an impact your addiction is going to have on you, because at least you're putting yourself in a position to share the problem with other people. That's releasing you from guilt. That's releasing you from shame. Although it does not feel like that when you first start sharing, but then there are people who can help you. There are people who can tell you like, yeah, dude, I actually went through the same thing. And that can be a very liberating experience, especially when it comes to guilt, when you feel like you're the only one doing it. But then you realize, wow, this guy went through the same process, right? Or you put yourself in a position where somebody can tell you, this is what I did to fix that specific part of my problem with pornography. And guess what? Now you have access to a solution. So the question that most men usually ask me at this point is, JK, how honest should I be? Like, really, I know you're saying be honest, but obviously if you've been through this problem yourself, then you know it's not the easiest thing in the world. Well, when I work with my one-on-one clients, we have something called the Reboot Circle. And Reboot Circle is simply a group of people that you pick deliberately, who are people that you can be honest with at varying levels about your porn and masturbation addiction. And these people could include your coach, a counselor, a therapist. If you're religious, maybe a pastor or a brother in the church. It could be somebody in a self-help or recovery group. Maybe it's even your doctor that you just talk to once in a while when you go for a checkup, right? But each of these people are people that you can be honest with at varying levels. That way, no one person gets overwhelmed with everything and knows all your deepest, darkest secrets, right? So the concept of the Reboot Circle is very helpful because it allows you to release a lot of the secrets that you're holding within you without feeling the pressure, without feeling bad about what I call it vomiting on one person. Of course, in a program like our group coaching program, the Porn Reboot Intensive, there are multiple reboot circles, there are multiple people that you can share with, including the group as a whole. So when it comes to how honest should you be, the more people that you have to share with, the easier it's going to be for you to share everything. Now, the next question guys usually ask me at this point is, well, JK, when should I not be honest? Should I just be radically honest with everybody? Aren't there real world consequences? I mean, JK, I'm a leader in my community. JK, people think that I'm this completely different guy. They think I'm conservative. JK, I've been living a double life. I've been completely against pornography and I've been verbally against masturbation and all these different things, but I'm doing them in my life. I'm going to come out as a hypocrite. Well, here's the only situation where you should not share everything, and that is when it has the potential to hurt somebody. So I'll give you an example. I had a brother in our public group, let's call it that, who reached out to me and said, JK, should I share my porn addiction with my adult daughters? And I do believe his daughters were, you know, maybe early 20s or late teens. Like, should I share it with them? These would be the first people that he would be sharing it with. And I was like, bro, that is not a good idea, right? Why? Because I'm really close to my daughters and they look up to me. Listen, if you are a father figure, if you are a role model to somebody, and especially if it is family, okay? Family dynamics can get very complex. You could be a role model to somebody else and share that and their circumstances for that. But because family dynamics are complex, your children are not really the people you want to share it with. Now, I do have some clients who have shared it with their children, but usually these are individuals whose children are adults and they usually share it with the men. And it's gone both ways. This is not something I suggest to my clients. I've also had clients who were like, oh my God, I'm making so much progress. And I told my daughter and my son-in-law. And now, they don't let the grandkids come over to visit anymore, right? So you gotta be careful, that creates pain. Maybe when your wife is in her 8 month of her pregnancy, that might not be the best time to say like, honey, I have a porn addiction. I have a sex addiction. I have masturbation addiction, right? Again, it might hurt more than one person. If you know that your wife is prone to deep depression or your partner has a history of suicidal tendency, or if she was previously traumatized in a past relationship by somebody who had the same problem as you, that doesn't mean you shouldn't share it with her immediately, but maybe it's something that can be shared down the road. The disclosure process is something you discuss with your therapist, is something that you discuss with your coach as well. So you do want to be careful about that. But brothers, the second rule of rebooting is be honest. Very important. I'll speak to you on the next video where we will be talking about the third rule. I'll see you then.